Hi, I'm Caitlin. I'm one of the youth librarians at Skokie Public Library, and joining me today is...
Desi! Today we are talking about something that I thought was really cool since I was little. Tornadoes.
Did you know that your dad and I used to call you Little Tornado when you were a toddler?
Because I left a trail of destruction in my path.
That and you were full of wind. Pee-hoo!
Very funny. Back to tornadoes. The thing that really interests me is that they are mostly wind. How do we go from a pleasant, breezy afternoon to Category 5 winds? It's scary.
It is a little scary, and it's absolutely okay to feel that way. But one thing that always makes me feel a little better when I'm scared is to learn more about that scary thing. Knowledge gives us power. So even if we can't control a tornado, knowing more about it gives us some control over how we react to it. So let's talk tornado. What do we know?
Well, we know that tornadoes are rapidly rotating columns of air that form inside storms, but not just any storm. They come from special storms called supercells. Supercells are the biggest, baddest storms around. They usually happen when cold air in the atmosphere is above a layer of warm, wet air. Warm air rises, and cold air is heavier than warm air, so they start swirling around and generally causing trouble. If they swirl around just right inside that giant, towering storm cloud, that produces a vortex.
A vortex?
When something is spinning really fast, it makes the shape of a funnel.
Ah, okay. So that's why tornadoes are called funnel clouds.
Actually, a tornado and a funnel cloud are not the same.
Say what?
Basically, a funnel cloud is a baby tornado.
Aww.
Oh, it's not that cute. A funnel cloud is just a tornado that hasn't touched down yet.
Don't all funnel clouds touch down?
They don't. And funnel clouds that don't touch down look scary, but are not necessarily dangerous.
So... back to
No way. Funnel clouds are potential tornadoes and should be treated as if they were dangerous. Would you want to cuddle a baby shark?
Do 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 do.
Mom!
Sorry. So, a tornado happens when swirling warm and cold air inside a supercell form a vortex which touches down and causes massive destruction.
You got it.
Yes.
But not all tornadoes are the same. Did you know there's a scale to measure their strength?
I actually did know that. The Enhanced Fujita, or EF scale. Scientists look at the damage a tornado does after it passes, and they assign it a number.
Right. There are six categories on the EF scale. EF 0 is the weakest category with gusts up to only 85 miles.
That's still faster than the fastest highway speed limit in Illinois.
And EF5 is the strongest, with wind gusts over 200 miles per hour.
Yikes. Okay, I may have overstated the whole knowledge is power thing because I just learned a lot about tornadoes and they seem pretty scary.
Yes and no. They are definitely scary. And there's a lot that scientists still don't know about them, but we have a lot of good information that can keep us safe. Now, when meteorologists see the sign for tornado conditions,
like a supercell with warm undercurrents,
they can give us a lot of warning so we can stay safe. But you know what I always say?
Haven, stop messing with my Legos?
Yes! And wait a minute, this is what you always say!
Oh! You mean the best way to learn a new concept is through a catchy song?
Yes, and I have a song about staying safe around tornadoes.
Well, if you sing a catchy song, you'll never get it wrong.
When you hear tornado watch, be prepared. Be concerned, stay alert, and be aware. There's a fair chance it will miss us, but the weather looks suspicious, so there could be something brewing in the air.
Okay, but... what about a tornado warning?
A tornado warning means a twister's near, and it's possible that one could soon appear. It's important not to panic, keep your wits and don't be frantic, hunker down and stay indoors until it's clear.
So what you're saying is that weather prediction is pretty great, and even though meteorologists don't know everything there is to know about tornadoes, they know enough to give us lots of warning about dangerous weather patterns so that we can keep safe.
Yes.
Okay, I can live with that. Now, let's get to work. Today, we are going to make our own cute little baby tornadoes.
You mean a vortex.
Baby tornado. For this experiment, you're going to need a jar or a 2-liter bottle from the recycling, some water, and some oil. Fill your jar about 2/3 of the way up, then add about 1/4 cup of oil to the top, seal it up, then spin.
Once you've given it a good spinning, let it sit and watch your funnel cloud. See if you can make it touch down.
Thanks for making landfall with us today, junior meteorologists. We will see you next time. Until then, keep on spinning!